The naive ticket machine will have this structure like any other classes, where there is an outer layer that gives the name to the class, and inner body enclosed into the two curly braces, which contains fields that hold the state, that hold the value of some variables permanently. The constructor that initializes the fields to a proper value and makes it possible to have the object being created correctly, and so that the methods will be able to immediately use the fields. Then there are the methods that are different from the constructor because they always need to have a return type, whether it's void or non-void, while the constructor never has a return type. The void return type doesn't when there is a when there is a void method, the return type is the returns, there is no return statement. When there is a return type in the method, then there must be at least one return statement. Accessor methods will provide some information about some fields to other methods or other objects, to other places. And mutator methods will change the state of a field. So that's it. We have the fields, the constructors, the fields, the constructor, and several methods in the body of a class. The exercise. If I remove the parameter cost from the ticket machine, so that the constructor will have no parameters, I can't compile it because it cannot find cost, but it will work if I give the fixed price of 1,000, and so any ticket machine that will be created will have a fixed price of 1,000. I can create a different constructor with the parameter and leave this one Awesome. Let's create also the empty method. Void empty that will not take any parameters. It's a mutator method that will change the total to zero. It will reset this. Reset this field, okay. So so now let's test. Create a ticket machine that has this fixed value of 1000 cents, so I don't have to provide any actual parameter when creating the object. With the old one, I still have to give it a price parameter. If I sell 1000 cents and print ticket, and now find total. I think it's the coins. And what should I do exactly now? So, and to remove all okay, so I have created a ticket machine. I have inserted some money. I have printed some tickets. Check the total. How can I check the total? It gets balanced. It will return balance. So what I need to do is also create a method that is an accessory method that will for the purpose of the test I can just inspect the ticket machine and see that now the total is 1000, and if I call the empty method and see again what does the total, what is the total value, it is 0.